And now we will learn how to customize QuickBooks forms. In this case, it means making a rent receipt for your tenants. Transaction documents in QuickBooks include things like estimates, invoices, sales receipts, but the credit memo document is the one that we need to use to give a rent receipt. So we will change a credit memo into a rent receipt. This is because a credit memo changes a tenant's or customer records in the way that a rent receipt would for a regular tenant. It has the same effect regarding the type of transaction it is. You can explore other possible changes from the windows we open, but we're only going to change the title from rent receipt, from credit memo to rent receipt. Even though there are many things you can edit, you could add or remove columns in a particular template for the document, you could change the position of the fields, you can add or remove fields, and you can even put a company logo. But again, the only thing we're going to do to customize our credit memo is change the title to rent receipt. So let's open up a credit memo and take a look. From the main menu, we click Customers, Create Credit Memo or Refund. And here it is. Now, in the title bar of the window, it says Create Credit Memo Refund. But you can see when you look at the details of the credit memo, of all the different fields that are on the screen, there's one that says Template. And QuickBooks comes with two different credit memo templates. Observe the fields and the column headings that are in the one that says credit memo. But if I choose this template, notice the title changes to return receipt, and notice some of the fields change here. So QuickBooks already created two templates. And even though this one says return receipt and might have a different look to it, it's still a credit memo. It still has an effect on the tenant's balance and the same effect in the general ledger chart of accounts when you record it. Now, there are three steps to making a new template. You have to copy an existing template, you have to change the name, and then save it on the template list. After that, you can do whatever you want with it and make it look the way you need it to look. So again, let's copy an existing template and then change the name. Then it's on the template list and then we can do what we want. So how do we do that? Well, in the formatting tab of the ribbon, right under the word formatting, you can click Manage Templates. And now you get the Manage Templates window. And again, there are two that already exist. Now, in order to make one for yourself, you have to copy an existing one. So the best thing to do is to choose one that looks the most closest to the way that you want yours to be and copy that one. Then you can customize it. So we'll click on the one that says Custom Credit Memo. Then while that's selected, we click Copy.